Hey everyone, Carlo here. Welcome to my watch vlog. This is my YouTube channel that's dedicated to my ongoing beginner's journey in the world of watches. Please do take note that I am not a horology master nor an expert. I'm not claiming that. I'm just really enjoying this newfound hobby and I just want to share the stuff that I pick up, the things that I find interesting in this ongoing journey of mine in watches. And in today's episode, I'm going to share with you my latest pickup. This is my unboxing of the Seiko Dark Manta Ray. Oh, ganda ng pangalan. Really nice name. Let's go. Now, before we get started, I want to introduce all of you to my incredibly cute, fluffy, just bathed, because he really just took a bath, cat. This is Dusty. Dusty, say hi to my watch vlog. Say hello to all the humans watching today. Woo, zhoo, zhoo, zhoo. Okay, and a quick wristwatch check of the day. I am wearing the Seiko Sumo Paddy. This is one of my favorite Sumo watches currently. I've been wearing it a lot. I love the color. I love the fit. Fits perfectly on my big chunky wrist. And with that said, tara, let's take a look at the Dark Manta Ray. Okay, so let's do it to it, guys. So this is the Seiko Dark Manta Ray. And as you guys can see with the box, it looks special. It's not your typical boring carton Seiko box. Speaks to the limited edition or the specialness, if that's a word, of the watch. Black blue. If you pop it open, I actually already wore this, but yeah, from the Prospex line. It says over here, save the ocean, and that's important. Here's the watch. But before we even get to the watch, allow me to talk about the Save the Ocean initiative. So that one is not just marketing. It's not just them taking advantage of the sea to sell to people who love the sea. This initiative actually funds. If you buy watches like this, from the Save the Ocean collection, Seiko actually uses some of the money to fund initiatives that conserve, protect, and save our ocean. So I actually will link down below to an article where they were talking about how they partnered with several organizations to help save and conserve endangered species all around the world. So if you want your products to stand for something, or if you want to buy stuff that have a cause, this is a nice line. It's a really nice cause. And it actually made me appreciate the Save the Ocean line more of Seiko. But anyway, as you guys can see, this is the watch itself. The main star is the dial. You have shades or outlines of manta rays swimming in what looks to be the ocean, for which makes up the design of the actual dial of the watch. Now this one, compared to the other Save the Ocean pieces I've seen in the past, is the absolute best in my opinion. I've seen the others wherein it was just waves, or the previous manta ray collection. That one looked more like a toy in my opinion. Again, don't bash me. We all have our own personal taste. But this one, I just absolutely love the color. This one for me is a home run in terms of design, in terms of overall look, in terms of quality and price and value. This one is just friggin' awesome. The case is actually 45 mil. Overall length is 47.7. It's not too thick, as it comes in at 13.2. It is water resistant up to 200 meters. If you want to go take this to the beach or go diving, that should work. In terms of the movement, it has the 4R36 caliber of Seiko, an automatic with manual winding capacity movement, power reserve of 41 hours. It has sapphire crystal for the case, and it has a day-date complication with a magnifier over here at the 3 o'clock position. This one also has anti-reflective coating on the inner surface, and you do have Lumi Bright on the hands, indices, and even on the bezel. You have a unidirectional rotating bezel, which is easy, and the click is satisfying to hear. If you take a look at the screw case back, you have special edition written on the back, and you do have a screw down crown here on the 4 o'clock position of the watch as well. Now, one thing I want to point out about the watch is that the color is absolutely stunning. It is not your typical, you know, royal blue color, which we usually see with Seikos or with blue watches. And allow me to get like another watch to show a comparison. So this is another one of my favorite Seiko blue watches. This is the Seiko Captain Willard watch. And as you guys can see, the blue on this one is more metallic, brighter in shade. This one is a little bit more faded. You can even see it on the strap, how the color of the blue is different between the two. I also love the contrast that they did with the black bezel with the blue face on this one. So I just feel that this one has a little bit more character. But this one, of course, is just also something else. So it really boils down to your overall preference. Now, when it comes to improvement with the watch or issues that I have with it, I just have two. The first one is that the buckle, as you guys can see over here, is just absolutely massive. So if you are used to like normal size buckles, like let's for say the one that you see with this watch, this one is kind of on the bigger side. So I'm not sure if that's an issue for people, but I do find it big. So it kind of extends almost close to the top of my wrist already. So it is a big buckle. Secondly, the movement is good, but the back of my head, they would have preferred if they used a 6R35, the one with that with 70 hours power reserve. But yeah, overall, it's still pretty solid. Internationally in the US, this one sells for almost around $600. In the Philippines, I think it sells for around 25 to 28. I can't remember the exact price, but you should be able to find it on different Seiko boutiques. I'll also try to look for it if it's available on the official Seiko boutique here in the Philippines and on Lazada, and I'll link that down below if ever you guys wanna purchase one. Ganda. Oh, to those who don't understand Tagalog, ganda means beautiful.
So should you buy the Seiko Dark Manta Ray? In my opinion, if the cost behind it resonates with you and you like slightly big, this 45mm watches that are color blue, and if you want something to remind you of the ocean, maybe you love diving, you love the sea, you love the beach, then you might want to check this one out. In fact, you can even pair it, I was thinking while I was taking a look at this watch, you can even pair it with some of my favorite perfumes or scents that remind me of the ocean a lot. So these two fragrances are from the House of Creed, my favorite perfume house. This one is Virgin Island Water. It's like coconut in a bottle. This one is Aerolfa, very, I think, aquatic. I think that's what you call it. But yeah, these two fragrances remind me a lot of the ocean. So if you wear this watch with these two, I know we're in lockdown, I know a lot of people still can't go out. That's the case here in the Philippines. It will give you a very oceany beach vibe. Now, before we wrap up the vlog, I just want to share with you one more item I want to unbox. This is a collaboration between Horology Matters. They are, I was about to say sneaker shop. They are a watch shop here in the Philippines together with Caliber. They are a magazine. So this is their new watch case. So I have the box over here. You have the Horology Matters logo here at the top. I have an unboxed version here for easier reference. Over here, the color is black and some sort of like nice faded green. You have the Caliber branding at the top, and then you have the same tag and some sort of like a carabiner hook here attached to the side of the case. You have the Horology Matters logo here at the back, and if you pop it open, you can actually put your watch here regardless whatever piece. I think it will fit like a variety of watches, different sizes, and it should keep it secure if you want to travel around or if you want to bring watches with you. This one sells, I think, for around 1,300 pesos. I will link it down below in case you guys want to buy one. And with that said, I hope you guys enjoyed this very quick watch unboxing. As usual, this is Carlo. Guys, check out my main channel. It's all about sneakers. It's all about gadgets. It has over 740,000 subscribers already. If you're into that kind of stuff, make sure to check that out. I will link it down below so you can also subscribe to that one and enjoy the content that we have over there. Also, I will link down below to the YouTube channel of my wife. It is in Tagalog though. She talks about entrepreneurship, business, personal finance, but it is in Filipino. So if you do live in the Philippines or if you can understand Filipino, check that channel out. This is Carlo signing out. Peace. God bless. What's up? Boom.